a great time for that.
Let me ask you about writing.
So my process is really interesting, and I get in arguments with people all the time because I'm unconventional in everything that I do. I do not follow the rules.
Okay.
So I don't like storyboard or write. It's all visually. When I close my eyes, I can just like see my story. I know it in my head. It's organized in my head, and I want to try and not use many words in my story because I want it to be very visual. And the thing that I really like about comics and like especially manga again is like the emotional expressions and body language. Like manga has the panels where it's like focused on the hands or like this like subtle shapes of the eyes or the mouth to convey certain emotions, and I'm really sensitive to that in general. Like in reality, like I have social anxiety because when I look at a room, I know how everyone's feeling based on their body language. Oh. And like, I'll get really anxious.
We have too much information.
Exactly.
And you're sort of trying to read things and everyone's completely self-unaware.
I know. And we're so logocentric and like, isn't it like 80% of communication is nonverbal? So I'm just like, what? So I want to explore that again, like through the imagery of my comic and like, yeah, not using words in the whole process to not be word-based. It's just all visual.
You know what, though? This is just... you need words to slow people down. Because if you can spend, like, I spent a month making this beautiful comic, and you read it in 15 seconds.
Well, I had a partner. He's huge into, like, webtoons, which is the Korean version of comics. He doesn't even read the words. He just scrolls, and he knows the story through the images. I'm like, are you even reading that? He's like, no, I know what's happening because of the pictures.
Oh, my God.
And he'll just tell me the story. Like, when he reads to me, and he'll be like, the picture, and he, like, thinks sound effects, and just, like, tells the story in his own way. And I'm like, he actually has like dyslexia too, so like reading to him is like whatever, like it doesn't matter. So it's really interesting, and he just flies through the series. Like he reads them fast.
See,
but you know, that's a type of, you know, learner in person.
Yeah
right? So it's funny, and that, but that's how he enjoys comics. It's just the images, right?
Wow.
But that's a good point, that the words, you know. And there is going to be parts where, because I want to get into philosophical concepts where the characters are kind of like getting into these deep conversations. But yeah, to make the visuals very detailed too, like in some mangas, like you said, like Nausicaa, like everything is so richly. I want people to get lost in the visuals, you know, and in the panels. I want them to be very complex, and like how my line work is so busy. Like I want to communicate through the lines almost.
I feel like Japanese readers read differently.
Yes.
Like they consume it in a way that I'm like, because I'm sitting here like I'm working on a picture. I'm like, bridge, the scale's not quite right. And I'll like redraw things and get them just perfect and kind of reposition things and look for a composition. Mm-hmm. I'm like, if someone's like, yeah, and reading it in like an eighth of a second,
right, what's the point?
I'm like, I'm not drawing for him.
Exactly.
I'm drawing for someone who's going to stop and go, oh, you know, and like, and there are people like, that's how I
exactly
read sort of comic. Oh, look what they did. Or I see how you, oh, that's, there's like a way of consuming it.
Exactly.
Whereas there's a whole section of like a Japanese train station is like, you buy a book at one end of the stop, you know, one end of your ride, and at the other end, you just throw it out because you read a whole soccer story
exactly.
or whatever. And I'm like, and that's how they're designed, and that's how they're drawn. So they can be beautifully drawn, but you're looking at stuff going, this page took 8 minutes. Like I'll go through Shonen Jump and go, man, this is the most economically cheaply drawn. It looks good, but everything's a trick.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's like, oh, it's the one face shot that's probably took the most effort. This is like just.
Yeah, a lot of them just like use pictures that are just like digitized to look cartoony.
Or like, just like lines for, oh, that's 2/3 of your page is just cheating.
Exactly.
And I just looked through, this is bullshit. There's nothing here. There's right. like, and the actual story only takes like one, nothing happened.
Exactly.
You know, this
it's filler.
It's, the whole thing's filler, but like you're going, but this guy's schedule is 20 pages a week? Fill away, my friend.
Right.
You can't, that's inhuman. You know, like,
right.
you know, whereas artists in the West, like, oh, I'm making every little line
right.
just so perfect, and like and people will pay money for the originals, and it's just, they're sort of treated differently.
It,
you know?
Yeah, it's true. And yeah, because manga is so mass, like, again, it's like mass consumed and mass produced. So yeah, that's actually a good like observation, because yeah, maybe I could like bridge the gap and combine those two things.
How did you read them when you were a kid?
again, it was very image based. I was just captured by the art. Like, I'm also like snobby about the art that I like in manga. Like, I'm very particular about certain styles. Like, if they're too minimal or like cartoony or like not detailed, I don't like it. And like, if the eyes are too big and like, if it's too cartoony, I like the like manga that has more like realism to it. Like, yeah. The more detail, like, you
it's,
know,
it's amazing that there's, stuff, there's that much material that you can get. Like, nah, I don't like the way they do the eyes. This is War and Peace. This is Anna Karenina.
Right.
You know, like, yeah, but you know, the eyes are just,
yeah, like I'm very
and that's completely look. I don't have time to read 20,000 pages a day. I can only pick 100 of those pages, exactly. And that's what's produced every day. So yeah, the eyes better friggin' fit my preference. You know, yeah,
exactly what I.
Jeez, you know?
So it's, and there's so much, right? So you can be selective like that, like, oh, that art's beautiful, I'm gonna explore that manga, or like, yeah. And often the different genres do have different styles, like the shoujo stuff, it can be really cartoony or whimsical, or you have the stuff that's more like for an adult audience, so it's more, it has that realistic look to it. And yeah, and like, again, when I first would buy a manga, I would like flip through it and just look at all the art first. And then I would read.
Oh,
it.
Sure.
And yeah, then I would reread it again and again, and I reread them. Like, I'm someone who does reread manga a bunch, because every time I read it, I almost notice new things. It's kind of like when you rewatch something, you know, you can miss things. Or I didn't look at the sound effects the first time, because I was just too excited to like figure out the conflict and, you know, how's it gonna end.
I don't think I've read too many comics more than. Like, twice is rare for me.
Yeah? Oh, yeah. Man, I've reread some, like, 10... Like, Chobits, man, I reread that so much. Like, obsessively would reread it.
Wow.
And just because the art is so beautiful. Like, it's really... It's, like, just looking at your favorite art piece again and again. That's one thing, like, in my experience with manga is just, yeah, the art. Just being captivated by the art. And, yeah.
Jesus is adjusting my camera because I'm not. Normally, I don't lean into a conversation. Right. This is like, I love the subject. You know, this is, yeah. Oh, man.